Hey everyone, I'm John Reams, an exercise physiologist here at NCHPAD, and today, Carnesha and I are going to be engaging in some seated flexibility practices with you. So let's begin by setting our breath imprint. The reason we want to practice the way we're breathing before we start these flexibility exercises is it's going to help to draw our attention into the now so that we're not thinking about the future or the past. So let's begin by trying to inhale and draw the air up through our belly, into our ribs, and into our chest. And then when we exhale, we're trying to push the air out of our chest, down through our ribs, and out through our belly. Let's try that three times. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Great. Let's stack our posture into place now. We're going to try to set our ears directly above our shoulders and our shoulders directly above our hips. One way that we can do this is if we lower our hands to our sides and turn our palms to face back. When we inhale, we keep that position, and when we exhale, we rotate our palms to face forward and simultaneously think about pulling our shoulders down away from our ears. So let's try that again. Let's inhale and palms facing back, exhale, palms face forward. Inhale, palms back, exhale, palms forward. Inhale, palms back, exhale, palms forward. Awesome. Now, let's try to set our posture a little more deeply in place. And let's practice turning our palms up. We're going to exhale and slowly raise our arms, palms still up, trying to keep our arms extended and our shoulders down away from our ears as much as possible. From this position, we'll try to make a fist. We'll turn palms down and still keeping ears and shoulders directly above each other. We're going to rotate our wrists in one direction. As you do this, try to make the rotations larger. That's five. We'll do this for five more. Great. Relax. Breathe out. Let your arms come back down to this position where your palms are still facing upward. We're going to try that again. This time, let's try to rotate our wrists in the opposite direction. So we'll inhale, exhale, bringing straight arms, palms up directly ahead of us. We'll try to make that fist. We'll turn palms down, and we'll try to rotate our wrists in the opposite direction. If you don't remember which direction it was, that's fine. It's the movement that counts and the quality of the movement. We're going to do this three more times and relax. Now, let's try to bring our palms together. Let your arms rest on your thighs. Starting with your left palm, try to turn that away from your right palm. Then we'll try to bring the right hand over the left and interlace your fingers as much as possible. We're going to stay here for just a moment. Then we're going to inhale And when we exhale, we're going to try to fold our hands back towards our chin and bring our arms into contact with our ribs. Here we go. We're going to inhale. And on the exhale, try to rotate palms under, bringing arms close to the ribs. And we'll stay here for three breaths. We're going to inhale and exhale. Inhale through the belly. Exhale from the chest. Inhale through the belly. Exhale from the chest. And let's bring that back down and let it relax. Let's try the same thing, this time leading with the right side. So we'll turn the right palm to face away from the left. We'll bring the left over the right. Try to interlace the fingers. And we'll just rest here for a moment. If it's more difficult to turn one palm over than the other, that's fine. We're going to work within the range of motion that's available to each of us individually. So here, we'll inhale, exhale, try to roll those hands under again, bringing arms close into the ribs. We'll stay here for three breaths. Inhale through the belly. Exhale through the chest. Inhale through the belly. And this time, try to exhale from your belly. Really tighten the muscles of your core when you exhale. Let's try that again. Inhale through the belly and expand. Exhale through the belly and tighten. Good. Let's unfold that and let it relax. We'll work on a little bit of shoulder mobility now. We'll start with our hands at our sides. Let's begin with the left side. If your left side isn't as cooperative to movement as your right, that's fine. Again, we're going to work within whatever range of motion we each have as individuals. Another thing to think about is don't force any of these motions. As we move through these progressions, you stop at the point where you feel a marked increase in resistance occurring. We don't want to push anything into the state of pain, and we don't want to force anything. So let's begin rotating our left palm to face upward. We're going to inhale, and on the exhale, trying to keep that palm facing up, we'll bring it high, as high above our head as we can, and think about really dropping that left hip down into the seat and extending upward through this left side. We'll take three breaths here. In through the belly and expand. Out through the belly and contract. In through the belly and expand. Out through the belly and tighten. One more time. In through the belly and expand. Out through the belly and tighten. Great. And slowly bring that left arm down. We'll try the same thing with our right. Again, if both sides of your body aren't as cooperative to movement as the other, that's okay. We're working within the range of motion that we each have available to us as individuals. We're going to turn the right palm up as much as possible. You'll notice my right side doesn't move with as much fluidity as my left. Again, that's okay. We're working with the range of motion we have. We're going to inhale. We're going to exhale. And try to raise that arm only as high as we can without our shoulders creeping up towards our ears. Here, we're going to really try to let that right side or that right hip drop into the seat, elongate through the right side. Let's inhale. Exhale. As you exhale, think about all of that right side stretching out a little bit more. Two more times. Inhale and expand. Exhale and tighten. Inhale and expand. Exhale and tighten. Great. Let's bring that arm down. Let's try it with both sides now. We'll begin by turning both palms up or to face upward. We're going to inhale. And on the exhale, keeping shoulders down away from the ears, try to bring both hands up, palms meeting each other. On the exhale, push palms into each other and drive elbows outward. Let's do that two more times. Palms up, inhale, palms together, exhale. One more time, palms up, inhale, palms together, exhale. Great. Let's take it into the lower body now. If you can, with your right leg, reach either around the front of your knee or the front of your shin or underneath your thigh, whatever works best for you. We're going to try to raise that knee towards our chest. And then we're going to try to fold our ankle across the left knee. We're going to place the right arm on top of the right knee. Just get a little bit of weight into that leg. We're trying to open our right hip here. Let's take three breaths in this position. If you can, every time you exhale, imagine that you're sitting in warm sand and you're sinking a little more deeply into the warm sand every time you exhale. One more time. Great. Now, let's try to turn palms up as our wrists lay across our leg. We're going to inhale. And on the exhale, try to slide forward as much as you can, still keeping a long spine, not collapsing forward and down, but really trying to open the lower back and the hip. We'll take three breaths here. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale and expand the belly. Exhale and expand the belly. Keeping shoulders down away from your ears. Inhale. And exhale. We'll come back up slowly to that seated position. Let that right leg slide down across the left. With our left arm, let's turn that palm up. Let's inhale. Exhale, raising the arm up. In a diagonal, as we exhale, bring that left arm down as far as you can across the right side. You can place your right hand on your seat behind you. And we're going to try to rotate our torso, turn our chest as much as we can, and look over the right shoulder. We'll take three deep breaths here. One more time. We'll unwind it. Slowly bring that leg back up. We'll lower it back to the ground. We're going to repeat the same thing on the other side. Again, don't worry if both sides of your body don't move with the same degree of fluidity as each other. Another thing to think about is don't force your way into any of these motions. Stop at the point where you feel an increase in resistance occurring. That's where you want to take a deep breath in, exhale slowly, then see if you can stay in the position and maybe even enter into it a little bit more deeply. So, either reaching across your left knee or underneath your left thigh, whatever works best for you. We're going to try to bring that left leg up. We're going to try to rotate the leg over so that the left ankle is sitting on top of the right knee. With our left arm, we'll put just a little bit of weight into that top of that left knee. We'll take three breaths here. Inhale and expand the belly. Exhale and contract the belly. Inhale and expand. Exhale and tighten. Inhale and expand. Exhale and tighten. Great. We'll turn palms up. Try to place arms against the leg. We're going to inhale. And when we exhale, try to slide forward as much as you can, still keeping that long spine position. We don't want to collapse forward onto ourselves. We'll take three breaths here. Again, imagining that warm sand every time you exhale. You sink a little more deeply into that sand. One more time. Shoulders down away from the ears. We'll come back up slowly and we'll let that left leg slide down across the right. We'll take our right arm. We'll try to turn the palm up as much as we can. Let's inhale. Exhale. Take the arm up and diagonally bringing it down across that left leg. Still trying to maintain that long spine. Don't force your way into the movement. We'll take the right hand onto the chair behind us. We're going to try to turn our chest or rotate our chest toward the left. We're trying to look over the left shoulder, still keeping the shoulders down away from the ears. We'll inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. We're going to slowly unwind it. Bring that leg back down to the floor. And that's it. That's your seated flexibility routine. You can use all of these movements. You can pick and choose the ones that work best for you. Develop your own practice to suit your needs. If you found this content to be meaningful to you, then please like the video, leave a comment, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and share this with anyone that you think might benefit from it.